Histotripsy is the first completely non-invasive, non-ionizing, and non-thermal cancer ablation method. It can also be used for other applications outside of cancer. Histotripsy works by using very short, high-pressure sound waves that we focus down to a single point in the body to generate what we call a cavitation bubble cloud. These cavitation bubbles rapidly expand and collapse and non-thermally destroy a target tissue into basically a liquefied debris. So you're basically taking a tumor and selectively destroying the cancer cells while preserving critical structures like blood vessels, bile ducts, and other tissues that we don't want to destroy. The major benefits of histotripsy are that it's completely non-invasive, and because it's non-thermal, we're able to treat with very high precision while preserving critical structures, so things that you wouldn't want to kill along with a tumor. So healthy tissue within the organ, nerves, bile ducts, blood vessels. So having these features really allows it to be well tolerated and potentially expanded to patients who can't receive other types of cancer therapies. It's also image guided, so we're able to be able to target non-invasively, but see on an image where the clinician wants to treat in order to deliver the therapy with better safety and effectiveness. So we have a lot of projects in our lab that's really looking at developing histotripsy for other applications, ranging from soft tissue tumors, bone tumors, brain cancer, breast cancer, and many others that we're very interested in. And even outside of cancer, we're looking at things like uterine fibroids, other tissue types where you'd want to non-invasively be able to remove a tissue from the body. And ultimately, histotripsy has a lot of benefits, so it can potentially replace surgery, replace ablation, other interventional procedures where you actually need to kill the tumor. But we've also seen exciting evidence that you may be able to use this histotripsy to actually stimulate an immune response and combine with other therapies to make them more effective for late stage systemic versions of the disease. So ultimately, we think histotripsy has a huge potential across the full landscape of cancer care, but we're still learning and there's a lot of research to be done in order to unlock its full potential. In October 2023, histotripsy received FDA approval for the treatment of liver tumors. There's also clinical trials going on for kidney and pancreatic cancer, also applications that we're really focused on. So it's currently available and systems are being deployed in hospitals all across the country, as well as a couple other sites outside of the United States. I'm Eli Vlaisavljevich, Associate Professor in the Department of Biomedical Engineering at Virginia Tech, and this is Histotripsy Explained.